Well, more now on the situation at New South Wales, Queensland state line. A reality TV crew being blamed for the border closing again. Let's bring in New South Wales Cross-Border Commissioner James McTavish. James, good morning to you. Thanks for your time this morning. In hindsight, was the decision to grant this TV crew an exemption a mistake?
Look, I think most people that are living regionally are concerned about, you know, the possibility of COVID coming into their community. I think the person that has left Sydney and come to Byron under, you know, an essential worker permit has, you know, done so legally. What they've done in the Northern Rivers is subject to further inquiries and investigations. But, you know, I think that everybody in the Northern Rivers right now that's been locked down is probably, you know, wishing that person was not in their community over the weekend.
Yeah, look, absolutely. And we know that plenty of film crews have actually set up in northern New South Wales during the pandemic. This case, does that now mean that process will perhaps be reviewed?
Look, I'm not sure as to what the process will be, you know, going forward in New South Wales. We do know that there are many thousands of people that move around New South Wales performing essential work every day, and a lot of them come out of Sydney. I think that most people would like for there to be, you know, greater surety around the movement of those people. But if we were to turn the tap off, then, you know, a lot of parts of regional New South Wales would cease functioning. You know, a lot of these people are providing, you know, those really necessary essential services to these communities. Most of them, the overwhelming majority, do the right thing, and unfortunately the actions of one individual appears to have had some pretty substantial consequences.
It's a hard balance, isn't it? It's a really, really difficult balance, and as we open up further, you're going to see more and more of this. What does this do, for example, to the crossing Queensland border now and vice versa?
Yeah, so for people that are in Tweed and Byron, they essentially revert to the rules that were in place a couple of weeks ago. They can still cross to access medical services. They can still, you know, get essential, you know, goods like their groceries if they need to in Queensland. But it means that you can only go across to work if you're an essential worker, and that's a pretty, you know, slim list of occupations. It includes things like doctors and nurses. It includes things like people that are operating the essential infrastructure. But it doesn't allow people who are involved in construction and retail. It doesn't allow teachers when term four goes back if the lockdown's still in place. And it doesn't allow people who, you know, would otherwise like to go to work, but they're outside of those essential work categories.
Yeah, I mean, there's going to be thousands of people who aren't going to be able to cross that border now. And as you say, something they rely on or do maybe numerous times in a day. Do you think Queensland and the Queensland Premier had any other choice but to do this, take this action?
Well, look, we would like for there to be better arrangements for people in border communities, even in those lockdown areas in New South Wales. People can still go to work. If they can't work from home, you know, if they work in a supermarket, if they work providing, you know, those essential retail services, if they, you know, work at a business which requires them to be face-to-face, they can still go to work in New South Wales. And look, the other part there is that there's a stack of Queenslanders who work in New South Wales every day as well, so they can't get to work today either. We'd like for something to be, you know, a bit more proportionate to what is happening in New South Wales. You know, we'd like for people to still be able to go to work. We'd like for people to be COVID safe. And I think as we move forward, as more people get vaccinated, as more people, you know, are able to work in and around regional New South Wales with an easing of restrictions over time, we'd like more people to be able to cross the border every day.
I think, look, this goes for, obviously, Victoria, New South Wales as well. Looking ahead, have you had any dealings yet or any discussions with your counterparts in Victoria and Queensland about what's going to happen in the next couple of months and whether or not the greater public will be able to travel across the border to Queensland, across the border to Victoria, or Victoria into New South Wales and vice versa? Any preliminary discussions on what that might look like and the timeline?
Yeah, look, we're very cognizant of the fact that people are looking for some firm dates, you know, particularly those involved in tourism and hospitality. You know, people want to book their holidays as well, you know, for the end of the year, and people want to have surety about being able to go to work in the immediate future as well. We've had those conversations with Victoria and Queensland. We'll continue to do so. New South Wales is in a great position from a vaccine point of view, but we know there's patchiness in regional New South Wales. You know, there are some communities that are sitting at around 55% first vax, while others are sitting well above 90. So, you know, that patchiness is of great concern. We're hoping, though, that the other states will catch up a bit. We're hoping that the evenness, you know, is made available in regional New South Wales, and that as we look to reopen in the next couple of months, that people will be able to cross the border if they're vaccinated and in the fullness of time, for everybody to be able to cross the border to do the things that they want to do every day.
Yeah, would be nice to see our families for Christmas.
The clarity, yeah.
Thank you, James. Always appreciate your time.
Very good operator, always very measured. James McTavish, Cross Border Commissioner.